prospects for education specifically and special needs in particular?
Well, you know, I think education has always been a priority of the legislature. You know, we will be looking at what the requests are. You know, we do know that there are lots of challenges in the system. Mm-hmm. You know, I've always been a proponent of empowering schools. Mm-hmm. I've been a proponent of getting the dollars to the schools and the classrooms, because I think that that's the most important investment we can make. Mm-hmm. So again, you know, as we look at the budget and the budget request, we'll be looking, I mean, I will definitely be looking at finding ways to get the additional dollars into the schools and into the classroom.
Okay, but between the allocation of the Ways and Means Committee, assuming that the governor approves the budget, releases the funds,
right,
there is this entity called the Department of Education.
Yes.
That is the proverbial middleman.
Right.
Okay, now we can go on and on about the Department of Education. You're elected governor. How do you move that entrenched bureaucracy with thousands of employees and get that money to the schools so that, in fact, we can see growth that you're talking about?
I mean, you know, it's a couple of things, obviously. You know, as I've chaired the Education Committee, I've talked with lots of different people on the issue. I do know that governors can have significant impact. You know, I know... for example, that Governor Romer in Colorado used to actually get engaged with the Department of Education on a weekly basis. And so, you know, I would intend to be active. There's lots of interaction. There are lots of state departments that interface with the Department of Education to get things done. I would drive the weighted student formula to be as high as it can be, because that's the budget that gets to the schools. You know, I really believe that, you know, if I could wave a magic wand, I would do every single penny. 100% of the budget gets put into weighted student formula and let it, you know, I think we need to turn the department upside down, in the sense that I think the school is the most important entity within the department. And if they controlled the entire budget and bought services back from the bureaucracy, then you would very quickly see which things the schools want from the system, and which things are really not adding value to the mission of what happens at the school.
Well, Senator, that's a very good engineering solution, but it's still, there's the bureaucracy.
Right. Now, well, you know, my experience has been, as I've gone and, you know, I've interacted with many people throughout the whole system, from, you know, the Board of Education to the superintendent and complex area superintendents. You know, my experience has been they're all very dedicated professionals, you know, and they want to do what's in the best interest of the public schools. Mm-hmm. You know, and so I think it's really just changing the corporate culture, if you will, to really make an emphasis. And really, I think the most important entity is the school. Leadership at the school is important. So the principal, I mean, I've seen phenomenal changes when you get a really good leader as a principal. You can turn around a school. And it's really about ensuring that the bureaucracy supports the school rather than the school responding to the bureaucracy.